Hey folks, welcome to this demo. I'm Anirudh Raghunath, a program manager at Microsoft. In this demo, I'll be going over the following topics. I'll be going over what CI/CD is and what are its benefits. Next, I'll give you an introduction to GitHub Actions, how it works and how you can configure them. After that, we'll deploy a sample app to Azure Kubernetes Service using GitHub Actions. Finally, we'll go over a pre-configured real-world microservice application and see that it's simple to configure CI/CD in this case as well. So let's get started. What is DevOps? DevOps is a set of practices that works to automate and integrate the processes between software development and IT teams. It's an agile development practice to streamline software building, testing, and release. DevOps is often implemented using CI/CD. CI, or continuous integration, is an engineering practice in which members of a development team integrate their code at a very high frequency. Since integration has usually been a time and effort-consuming activity, CI tactics depend on automation tools that execute build and testing. CD, or continuous delivery, is the practice of ensuring that code is always in a deployable state. This means that all changes to code, new features, bug fixes, configuration changes, are always ready for deployment to a production environment. Now let's look at some benefits of DevOps. DevOps promises faster delivery of features, more stable operating environments, improved communication and collaboration, and most importantly, more time to innovate rather than fix and maintain infrastructure. Here are a few metrics. Organizations that have good DevOps practices on an average boast 200x faster deployments, 25x faster recovery time, 3x lower change failure rates. These are some significant metrics that really highlight the advantages of having optimal DevOps practices. There are many tools available to implement CI/CD, with the newest one being GitHub Actions. GitHub Actions enable you to create custom SDLC workflows directly within your GitHub repository. These workflows can be triggered using a wide variety of events and can help you build robust CI/CD pipelines to build, test, and deploy your code. These events include push, pull request, issue creation, forks, webhooks, and many more. They make use of pre-configured actions or tasks with over 3,000 actions available on the marketplace. This also includes the full suite of actions by Azure that let you connect to the cloud in an easy and consistent manner. Now let's start with the hands-on demonstration. I'm going to be using this Node.js Hello World app and will deploy it to Azure Kubernetes Service. To get us started, I've already configured a few things. I have provisioned an AKS cluster and have a container registry to store my images. As you can see, I have configured a very simple Docker file to containerize this app. Additionally, I have added two manifest files. The deployment manifest creates a replica set with two replicas that will pull the image from my container registry. Next, the service manifest will create a service of type load balancer. And this will point to the replicas created as part of our deployment. I have also configured two workflows, each to be triggered at different points of time. The first one is the pull request workflow. This will be triggered every time a PR is raised against the master branch. As you can see, I'm first building my container image. Next, I'm making use of Azure's image scan action, which internally uses Trivy and Dockle to find vulnerabilities and lint your image. I'm going to use this to scan for any known vulnerabilities my container image might have. This is also a good way to proactively prevent a vulnerable image to get deployed into our cluster. If the scan succeeds, I can merge the pull request into my master branch. This would also be a good place to add automated test cases. The second one is the CI workflow. This will be triggered every time someone makes a commit to the master branch. As you can probably tell, once our PR gets checked in, this workflow will be triggered. It contains two jobs. The build job will be used to first build my container image, tag it with the commit SHA, and push it to my container registry. Next, we have the deploy job. It makes use of multiple Azure actions. First, set the Kubernetes context to my cluster. Second, create the required namespace. Third, add a secret to the cluster to pull my image from my private registry, and finally deploy to the cluster using my manifest files. As part of configuring the actions, I have also created three secrets, namely the container registry username, its password, and the Azure credentials required to set the Kubernetes context. Let's jump into the command line real quick. I've already prepared all the commands I'm going to be using for this demo so that you don't have to see my butterfingers ruin the demo by making typos. First, let's get all the resources in the cluster in this namespace. As you can see, we currently have nothing deployed. Now let's create a feature branch and make a small change. I'm just going to edit the title of the app for the sake of this video. There we go. Now let's commit this and push it to my remote branch. To integrate our changes, let's create a pull request to the master branch. So to the feature branch, pick the correct repository, and we can see our changes over here. Now let's give it an appropriate description and create the pull request. There we go. Now, if you notice, the PR workflow has already been kicked off in the form of a check. If you click on the details link, you can see that our workflow is already running. It's building the container image and then it will scan it for vulnerabilities. For the sake of the demo, I'm going to pause and come back once it's done. As you can see, the check is now complete. Again, clicking on the details link will take you to the workflow run. Awesome, there were no vulnerabilities found. Let's move forward. Now that all of this looks good, I'll go ahead and merge this PR. Now, if you go to the Actions tab, as you probably guessed, our second workflow, the CI workflow, has been triggered. If you click on it and go to the details, we can see that the first job, which is the build job, has started running. I'm going to pause again and wait for the deployment job to complete. Great, now that it's done, our resources have been deployed successfully to Azure. Jumping back to the command line again, you can see that all of our resources have indeed been deployed to the cluster. Let's quickly grab the IP address of our service and use it to ping our app. And voila! You can see that the change we made has been successfully deployed to the cluster. Now obviously, this is just a sample app and configuring a full-blown enterprise application will take a bit more effort, but the overall structure remains the same. Let's take a look at an example. I'm going to run by you how we can deploy a complex application with multiple microservices involved. We have the rock, paper, scissors, lizard, swap application. If you take a look at the architecture, it contains multiple different microservices, each written in a different language. It also has a Cosmos DB instance and an Azure function, all bundled and deployed on AKS. For an app with so many moving parts, provisioning can become real tricky, real fast if done manually. So, we've configured a workflow to take care of this for us. As you can see, you can configure the trigger to work on specific paths. So this workflow will get triggered only if there are some changes to the ARM path, where we have stored all of our ARM templates, or if there are some changes to the workflow file itself. We use the login action by Azure to connect to the cloud, and then we use Easy CLI to provision the resources. Now, how do we deploy the different microservices? A clean way to do this is to have a separate workflow for each one, as so. Let's pick the Python microservice. Similar to the one before, it's configured to trigger only when there are changes to the Python directory. We've also included the path to the Helm chart we are using to deploy this to our cluster. The rest of the workflow file remains largely similar to the one we created in the previous example. The only difference here is that we are using Helm to deploy charts to our cluster instead of directly using manifest files. And there we have it, configuring CI/CD for an enterprise-grade application with multiple microservices using GitHub Actions. Let's quickly summarize what we've seen in this demo. We went over how we can configure workflows using GitHub Actions to create powerful and flexible CI/CD pipelines. We also saw that this functionality can be extended to enterprise-grade applications at scale. We looked at the suite of actions that Azure provides out of the box for Kubernetes, which allow users to seamlessly connect to their clusters and manage their workloads. A key point to note here is that K8s actions work not only for Azure, but for all other clouds as well as on-prem clusters. The workflows we configured for our deployment were created using one of the many starter templates provided by Azure, which allows users to quickly get started. That brings us to the end of this demo. The documentation to all the actions provided by Azure can be found at aka.ms/actionscd. For any further questions, you can reach out to me at my email address. I hope that this has been informational. Thanks for tuning in.